So we're going to generalize this notion of a Bellman equation to Bellman equations. And the way we're going to do that is by noting that in that previous derivation, the way that we were thinking about things is we capture this V here as the repeating structure that starts with the max A, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's actually this piece, this sort of infinite piece here. So the whole V consists of this sort of sub V in it. And this is why this piece gets substituted with the V in the equation, right?
Yeah, that makes sense. And you have an infinite number of these things going on forever and ever. And I notice an infinite number of left parentheses and not enough right parentheses.
Oh, no. This right bracket has traditionally represented the balancing of all left parentheses.
Oh, right. That's from Lisp.
Yeah, it's just a shorthand.
Nice. Nice Lisp. See? Lisp. Nice. Nice Lisp reference.
Thanks. So, but the thing is, because this is an infinite sequence, there's actually a number of other ways that we can group this infinite sequence. So let me draw another one.
Okay.
So we can also group the infinite sequence here and notice that it repeats like this. So this expression after the max, the starting from the R and then moving forward, repeats again here. And so we can actually make a new equation that depends on that substructure repeated. So let me write that out. So the idea is that we can actually just give a name to this big outer brace. So we'll call it QSA, and we'll say that it's equal to RSA plus the discount factor times the sum over next possible states, the probability of getting there, times max A2, or next max, of, and then there's that repeating structure again. So we can just plug in Q of S prime A prime for that. This gives us another Bellman equation that instead of starting at the S point, kind of starts after the action has started.
Well, wait, if it starts after the action has started, why isn't it Q of A?
Ah, okay, that's a fair question. So how could we have written the Q value of an action, the Q value of this point in the sequence, this way, the reward for leaving that state and taking that action plus the discounted value of the future. What's the problem with this?
Well, I see two problems. One is kind of mathematical and one is sort of semantic. So mathematically, it doesn't make sense because where did the S come from? In R of S come A.
Yeah, this is an unbound variable, right? So that's an error.
We can't have that. And the second is when you actually write it that way, so here you're arguing that Q is like V?
Yeah.
Right? So you're asking me what the qual view of A is, but the value of an action is meaningless except in the presence of the state where you're taking an action.
That's exactly right. So in particular, we're conditioning our reward on both the state and the action. So that doesn't really make sense to even be able to talk about what our future value is going to be if we don't really know where we started. So the idea here is that we start in some state S, we take action A, and then we proceed ever after.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that makes sense.